Kudzu has been a problem in the southern U.S. for decades, but now it's showing up across the north and in Canada. Dr. Louis Ziska with the U.S. Department of Agriculture's Agricultural Research Service, or ARS, says one theory for kudzu's spread is climate change.
It's just one of those really nasty vines that literally grows almost a foot a day under proper conditions. One of the things that has kept kudzu in check in the past has been basically cold winters. And as the winters warm, kudzu is essentially migrating northward. And so you're seeing it in locations where it hasn't been seen in the past.
Kudzu was planted in the South in the 1920s and 30s to control soil erosion, which it does quite well. But otherwise, it's useless and damaging.
It basically eliminates all the other species. There's only going to be kudzu. Kudzu is also a host for soybean rust. Kudzu is a sort of a super weed, if you will. One that we need to really keep an eye on, and one that we need to come up with new ways to try and detect, and of course, to try and manage. And that's really, really difficult.
Ziska says if your property gets kudzu,
if it's small enough, try and remove it, physically remove it. If, on the other hand, it's the size that you see behind me, the best thing you can try and do is to mow it or to keep the level of kudzu down so it doesn't spread.
And getting a goat is another option.
Goats love kudzu, and if you can get the goats to basically attack the kudzu, keep eating the kudzu, eventually the kudzu can be controlled.
Also, Ziska says ARS studies have shown that kudzu can be turned into a biofuel. In Beltsville, Maryland, for the U.S. Department of Agriculture, I'm Bob Ellison.